Shalom uvracha, sisters, brothers, holy souls of Israel, holy souls of humans around the world. Those are amazing days, days that are coming closer to those 3 weeks before the day of Tisha B'Av. In those days we are mourning and reminding ourselves of the destruction of the holy temples of the Creator. The destruction of those temples is reminding us of the destruction of our brain, the destruction of the tefillin that is the crown to our head. This is why the temples of the person called temples, because the brain is located between those two. The issue of the temple is that the temple was the house of prayer, like that it's written on the third one that will be built in our days, amen, that the Creator said, Ki Beiti, because my house will be called Yikare Bet Tefillah, the house of prayer, to all nations, Lechol Amim, that everyone will come and pray for him in his house, in the house of the Lord, in the house of the Creator, the house of God, the house of Hashem, the house of the one above. Now, what does it mean that the two temples been destroyed? The ruin, the destruction of the holy temple of the Creator, that we lost that understanding, that power of our mind to pray and to call the Creator from our daily issues that we're going through. When a person is going through a trouble, he will do whatever it takes to fix that trouble, everything except of praying to the Creator. He will call his lawyer, he will call his doctor, he will call his parents-in-law, he will call his enemies to help him, and he will not call God, and he will not pray. That is the destruction of the temple. And on that we're mourning, that we're trying to put effort in so many directions except of prayer. But when we will pray to the Creator from the bottom of our heart, and we will build our faith in a solid way, that we will know that all our needs are coming from Him, and that if we call Him with truth, we are being answered by His kindness and greatness. In that moment, the temples will be built, both of them as one, as the third one, the eternal one, and will host all nations from four wings of the universe to come and to call Him in His name in that glory day of redemption. May we see it with a happy heart and a wishing soul in our days, with healthy eyes, with all our beloved ones around us. Amen.
The world does not exist, because Olam Milshon Ne'elem, the world is just blocking the light of truth. The world calls Alma Deshika, world of light. It's just a fake.